this video, we will show you how to view or read SQL Server transaction logs and how they are important for SQL Server database users. Primary database is the place where the SQL Server stores all its information and also separates the physical record in MDF file. Meanwhile, the transactional information of these physical records is stored in a log file. Why we need to read SQL Server transaction log? Because it contains all the details of the transactions which are performed on the database. The transaction log captures all the basic DML operations like insert, update, delete, and also captures some DDL operations like create, truncate, and drop. This information can be used in forensics to find those records which have been deleted mistakenly, or if you want to recover lost data. Now let's check out the method of reading SQL Server transaction log. Transaction logs are very crucial information. This information cannot be read directly because the log data is not stored in human-readable format. In order to get the information from the logged operations, we use some undocumented functions which tells the way of reading transaction logs. Now let's check how to view SQL transaction log using fn_blog function. This function provides the facility to read SQL Server transaction logs and accepts two parameters like startLSN and endLSN. Now let's see how to use the fn_blog function. The first step is to create a database. The second step is to create the table in this database. And in the third step, with the help of fn_blog function, we can find out how many steps and processes were taken by the SQL Server to create the database and table. In the results section, you can see the number of steps taken by SQL Server for creating tables and database. Now in the fourth step, we will see what kind of data is available in the log file. In the fifth step, we will perform some insert, delete and update operations to determine how these operations are logged in the transaction log file. The sixth step will show the logged transactions which we have been performed. We can see in above steps how fn_blog function shows the captured transaction logs and made the transactions in human readable format. Now let's check out the consequences of using fn_blog. This function is useful when the user wants to view SQL transaction log, also can see the activities like page splits or objects being dropped. But the most important thing is that, using this undocumented function, the MS SQL Server allows users to use the function at their own risk. Now let's come to the conclusions. To a certain extent, the fn_blog function gives effective results. But since it's an undocumented one, the method can be too long, and it can also result in data loss. Now we bring the solution for you. SysTools SQL Log Analyzer Tool. Now let's check out the features. Using our software, you can analyze SQL log file transactions without any issues. You can quickly perform SQL LDF file recovery and can analyze multiple NDF file data and much more. Overall, our software provides you with the best and ultimate solutions. Hope you enjoyed the video. Log on to the given product page for more details and purchasing the product. For any query, mail us to support@systoolsgroup.com. Thank you for watching.